Namaste students, myself Sunil Kumar from the Department of Computer Science. Today we are moving to second session based on the chapter 2 Boolean Algebra, and today's topic is evaluation of Boolean expressions using truth table, Boolean postulates, principle of duality and properties of 0 and 1. In the last session we discussed about introduction to Boolean algebra, binary valued quantities, truth table, logical operators like AND operator, OR operator, then NOT operator. Today we'll move to our session now. Evaluation of Boolean expression using the truth table. If you want to create the truth table for any variables or any statements, then you have to follow the certain steps. There are some steps are there to create the truth table for any statements or any expression. The first step, determine the number of variable for n. Determine the number of variable. We have to see the what is the total number of variable. For example, the variable may contain 2 variables will be there, or 3 variable, or 4 variable, or 5 variable. Any number of variables are there will be present in a expressions. For example, any statement which contains n numbers or n variables. When there are n variable means we have to create 2 raised to n rows. We have to write the all the possible combinations. So we have to create 2 raised to n rows we should create. For example, 2 variables are there means there are only 2 variables x and y. Then truth table need 2 raised to 2 means 4 rows. 2 raised to 2, 4 rows are required. If 3 variable means 2 raised to 3, 8 rows are required. If 4 variable means 2 raised to 4, 16 variables are required. So like that you can write the total number of rows based on the 2 raised to n, or for n variable 2 raised to n. In second step, list the variables. First you have to list the number of variable, then every combination of 0 and 1 for the given variables. We have to list the variables, or we have to list the values. Normally we have to list the values for every combination of 0 and 1. There are 4 variable means, there are 2 variable means 4 combinations will be available. So all the 4 combination we should write. We should write all the 4 combinations. Then create a new column for each term of the statement or argument. Next you have to create, input is over means all that number of variables are over means. Next we have to create new term or new column for the new term. Any new terms are there means for the particular new term we have to create new statement or new column you should create. If two statements have same truth values, if the two statements have same truth values means then we can say they both are equivalent. Both the values or both the columns will have the same values means same set of values means then we can say the both the statements are equivalent. So we'll take one example. Example here, consider the following example, an expression f is equal to x plus y dash. Expression is x plus y dash. This expression has 2 variables. Remember, this expression has 2 variables. One is x and second one is y. It contains 2 variables x and y. So we require 2 raised to 2 means 4 rows are required. 4 rows are required. List the variables. The 4 rows we should write. Then list the variables. We have to list the variable every combination of x and y. For all the combination of x and y, we have to list the variables, or we have to list the data or values we should list. Then create a new column for new statement. A new expression is x is over, then y is over. Next, compared to this statement, y dash is required. Y dash is a new statement here or new variable here. For that we have to create the new statement and the fill the truth values of y in that column. Based on the y you should write y dash. We know how we can use a NOT operator, so we have to write y dash based on the y. Then final column that contains the values of x plus y dash. Here you will see the truth table. This is the truth table for the x plus y dash. Here I told first you have to list the number of variables. 2 variables are required. So two variables, one is x and y. If two variables are present, means total four rows are required. You return, you can see the four rows. Other than heading, we can see the four rows. Then second step, we have to write the, all the possible combination for x and y. Either x can be 0, y can be 0. X can be 0, y can be 1. Y x can be 1, y 0. And same x and y both also 1. So that is a, all the possible combination we can write. You should write all the possible combination in x and y. Then next we have to find the x, y dash. Next we have to find y dash. If you want to find the y dash, see the column y. In the y input is 0 means y dash should be 1. Second row we can see 1. Y is given as 1. So y dash should be 0. Then if y is 0 means y dash should be 1. In last column we can see, or last row we can see, y is equal to 1 means y dash should be 0. Based on the y, you should write y dash. You know the y dash or not operation. If x is equal to 0, x dash should be 1. If x is equal to 1, y x dash should be 0. Same here, y and y dash. Y is equal to 0 means y dash should be 1. If y is equal to 1, y dash should be 0. So that column is over. And last we can see the final column, x plus y dash. Here we should see the column x. We should see the first column x, and in between column y dash. Two column we have to AND. We have to OR. It's a plus operation. So we have to OR the two columns. First check 0 and y dash 1. 0 plus 1 or 0 or 1. By seeing the truth table, x plus y truth table, we can see 0 plus 1 means output is 1. Next we can see 0 and 0. See the column x and y dash. 0 plus 0, output is 0. 0, 1 plus 1 means output is 1. Last 1 plus 0, output will be 1. So you can see the final column, that is based on the x and y dash. We have to AND x and y dash, we have to AND. So we have to OR x and y dash, means we have to add that x plus y dash, x plus y dash. So 0 plus 1, means normally say 0 or 1 means 0 plus 1, that is 1. 1, 0 plus 0, that will be 0. 1 plus 1, that is 1. 1 plus 0, that is 1. So that is the Boolean expression, or is the truth table for the variable, for the statement x plus y dash. Here is a some problem. You can do the four problems. Problems are given. One is x plus y plus x dot y plus xy, x dot y. Next one is xyz plus xyz, xyz plus xyz. Then one more also there. Verify the truth table for following expressions. X plus xy is equal to x, x plus y is equal to x dot y. You have to verify that one. This is the some exercise problems. Next we will see the Boolean postulates. The fundamental laws of Boolean algebra are known as Boolean postulates. Postulates of Boolean algebra. The fundamental laws of Boolean algebra is known as postulates of Boolean algebra. Some fundamental laws or fundamental rules of Boolean algebra. These postulates for Boolean algebra originate from three logic basic functions, AND, OR, NAT, NOT operation. Normally we will use AND operation, OR operation, NOT operation. Based on these three logical functions, we will write the basic postulates of the Boolean algebra. Here is the four postulates. The first one is, if x not equal to 0, if x not equal to 0, then x should be 1, then x should be 1, and if x not equal to 1 means, then x should be 0. This is the first postulate. If only two values are possible, so if x not equal to 0 means, that will be should be 1. If x not equal to 1 means, it should be 0. The second one is OR relation, or it is also known as logical addition. 0 plus 0 equals 0, 0 plus 1 equals 1, 1 plus 0 equals 1, 1 plus 1 equals 0, 1. So this is OR relation. The next one is AND relation, logical multiplication. It says that 0 dot 0, dot means here AND, 0 and 0, it is 0. 1 dot 0, that 0. 1, 0 dot 1 equals 0. 1 dot 1, that equals 1. Meaning output is 1 when both the inputs are 1. The last one is complement rules. The complement rules, 0 dash. 0 dash is equal to 1. 1 dash equals to 0. Remember, that is actually the complement rules. The next principle of duality. Next theorem is principle of duality. This is a very important principle used in Boolean algebra. It is a very important principle used in Boolean algebra. Principle of duality states that changing each or sign into and sign. First you have to change any or sign is there, means plus is there, means we have to change that to dot. Whenever and is there, means that we should change to or. Normally changing plus to dot, changing dot to plus, replacing 0 by 1 by 1 by 0. Whenever 1 is there, means you have to change that into 0. Whenever 0 is there, that you have to change into 0. Remember, principle of duality states that changing plus to dot, changing dot to plus, replacing each 0 by 1 and each 1 by 0, that derives new Boolean expression. So, a new Boolean expression can be derived from existing one by changing plus to dot, dot to plus, replacing 0 to 1 and 1 to 0. Whenever 1 is there, you have to change that into 0. Whenever 0 is there, means that you have to change to 1. Whenever plus is there, means you have to change that into dot operation. Whenever dot operation is there, means we have to change that into plus operation. So, we can derive the new Boolean expression. Here is an example. Take the postulate 2, second postulate, logical addition. 0 plus 0 is equal to 0. 0 plus 1 is equal to 1. 1 plus 0 is equal to 1. And 1 plus 1 is equal to 1. Now you take the example. Apply the principle of duality. In principle of duality, plus is there, means you have to change that to 0. 0 is there, means you have to, plus is there, means you have to change that into dot operation. 0 is there, means you have to change that into 1. 1 is there, means that you have to change into 0. See the first expression here. First expression, 0 plus 0 equals 0. So 0 is there, that you replace by 1. Plus operation is there, change that into dot operation. Then 0 is there, change that into 1. Then after equals, 0 is there, output also you change that into 1. So it is 1 dot 1 equals 1. That is a new Boolean expression. So next one is 0 plus 1. So it is 1 dot 0 is equal to 0. Next we can see 1 plus 0 equals 1. So we can change that into 0 dot 1 equals 0. Last one is 1 plus 1 equals 1. So 1 should be changed to 0, plus should be changed to dot, 1 should be changed to 0, then finally 1 should be changed to 0. So it is 1 plus 1 is equal to 1. That should be changed as, that is changed as 0 dot 0 equals 0. This is actually known as principle of duality. Here is some example. The first one is x plus 0 is equal to x. X plus 0 is equal to x. So if you are going to apply the principle of duality, then it is x. X should be x. Plus is there, that is changed to dot operation. Plus is changed to dot operation. 0 is changed into 1. So it is x plus x dot 1 equals to x. Next is x plus 1 equals 1. X plus 1 equals to 1. That you can change as x dot 0 equals to 0, because plus is changed to dot, 1 is changed to 0. The next one is x dot x equals to 0. X dot x equals to 0. So here x plus x dot should be changed that plus 1 should be 0 should be changed as 1. So, x plus x equals to 1. Then, x plus x dot y plus z. X dot y plus z. That is a Boolean expression. You can change that into x plus y dot z. X plus y dot z. Next one is x plus xy is equal to xy. So, that we can change into x dot x plus y equals x dot y. So, plus is changed to dot operations, and dot operation is changed into plus operation. The next one is Boolean theorem. That are the fundamental laws. Postulate means that is the fundamental laws. The next is Boolean theorem. There are different Boolean theorems are there. The Boolean theorems can be proved by substituting all the possible values. We can prove the Boolean theorem by substituting all the possible values. So because only two possible values are there, one is 0 and 1. See, if you want to prove the any Boolean theorem, we can apply all the values, all the by substituting all the possible values for the variable that are 0 and 1. You can apply, first you have to apply 0, then you have to substitute 1. So this technique of proving theorem is called as proof by perfect induction. See, proof by perfect induction means applying or substituting all the possible values, substituting all the possible values for Boolean theorems. So then we can prove the Boolean theorems. That is actually known as proof by perfect induction. The first theorem here, it is properties of 0 and 1. Properties of 0 and 1. 0 plus x equals x. 1 plus x equals 1. 0 dot x equals 0. And 1 dot x equals x. These are the four properties of 0 and 1. Here the first one is 0 plus x equals x. 0 plus x equals x. If x is equal to 0, if x equals to 0, then you can see left hand side 0 plus x. 0 plus x. If x is equal to 0 means x should be replaced as 0. So it is 0 plus 0. 0 means because it is x, whenever x is 0, then equals to 0. So it is equal to right hand side. Right hand side. Then if x is equal to 1, if x is equal to 1, then left hand side is equal to 0 plus x. 0 plus x. Then 0 plus x is equal to 1. So x 1. 0 plus 1. 0 plus 1, according to the AND operation, it is 1. It is equal to right hand side. You can see the truth table. Because here you can see here truth table 0, x and 0 plus x. 0, all the possible combination 0 and 0. X we can give either 0 or 1. For x, we can give 0 and 1. 0 plus x, 0 plus 0, output is 0. 0 plus 1, output is 1. You can see the x and 0 plus x. Both the columns are identical. Both the columns have the same set of values. So we can say both are equivalent. The next one is theorem 2 here. 1 plus x equal to 1. 1 plus x equal to 1. You can prove that one by using, if x is equal to 0, first apply the x value as 0. Just apply the first value x as 0. Then left hand side LHS is equal to 1 plus x. You can see 1 plus x. That is 1 plus 0 because x value is x is equal to 0. So it is 1 plus 0 is equals to 1. Is equals to right hand side. Right hand side should be 1. The next one is, if x equal to 1, whenever x is equal to 1, then left hand side LHS equal to 1 plus x. 1 plus x, x value is 1, so it is 1 plus 1. 1 plus 1 because x value is 1, so it will give the 1 plus 1 is 1. So you can see output is 1. So it is equal to the right hand side. Here you can see the truth table. In the truth table, 1 is given and x is given. 1 is always 1, x either 0 or 1. So 1 plus x, 0 plus 1 plus 0. 1 plus 0 always 1. 1 plus 1 it is also 1. So output is always 1. So it is proved. The next one is next theorem. 0 dot x equals to 0. 0 dot x equals to 0. If that is the proof by induction. Left side you can see proof by induction. Right side you can see the truth table. If x is equal to 0, only two values we are applying, one is 0 and 1. If x is equal to 0, then left hand side LHS equal to 0 dot x. 0 dot x. X value is 0, so it is 0 dot 0. 0 dot 0. 0 dot 0 is equal to 0. So it will be right hand side. Same here, if x is equal to 1. If x is equal to 1, then left hand side 0 dot x. Left hand side you can see 0 dot x. It is a 0 dot 1 because x is equal to 1. 0 dot 1, it will be 0. So output is always 0. If you can see the truth table here, in the truth table 0 x and 0 dot x, 0 dot 0 0, 0 dot 1 output is 0. So output is always 0. So theorem, you can say it is proved. The last one is 1 dot x equal to x, 1 dot x equal to x. What is the x? That should be output. See here, if x is equal to 0, if x is equal to 0, 1 dot x, 1 dot x. So x is 0, so 1 dot 0. So 1 dot 0 is 0, x value is also 0. So it is proved. And here, if x is equal to 1, if x is equal to 1, then LHS, left hand side, 1 dot x, 1 dot x, 1 dot x means 1 dot 1. X value is 1, so it is a 1 dot 1, it is equal to 1. So we can say the theorem is proved. Which value is given for x, output is also same value. You can see the truth table here. In truth table, value 1 is given, then x also given, x 0 or 1. You can give x value 0 or 1. The x 1 dot x, see here, 1 dot 0, 1 dot 0, output is 0, 1 dot 1, output is 1. See the column x and 1 dot x, both the columns are identical, both the columns have same set of values, so it is proved. So here we reach the session today. In this session we discussed about evaluation of Boolean expression using truth tables, then one example, then Boolean postulates, basic fundamental laws of Boolean algebra, principle of duality, and basic theorem. The basic theorem, first one is properties of 0 and 1. So I'll wind up my today's session. Thank you.